it's an absolutely spiritual place for a lot of us. And so to see protesters there, for me, it's really disgusting. And for a lot of our RSL members and a lot of veterans I know around, not just Melbourne, but Australia, they're really disheartened and disappointed to see that, because it's not appropriate. It's an apolitical place. It is a strictly apolitical place, and it should never be used for protest. For me, yesterday, watching protesters not just standing on the shrine, but also to see them climbing on the plinths, to see them and to hear what's happened since, the disrespect they've shown that structure. It's more than a structure. The shrine is a cathedral, a tomb, a mausoleum. I'm trying to justify that by saying that the shrine is a place for people who fought for freedom. That's a miscategorization of the shrine itself, and that's trying to use the Anzac spirit, trying to use that Anzac memory for, I think, you know, completely misguided aims.
Obviously, there was a lot of broken glass. There'd been urination on the walls of the memorial, which is absolutely disgusting that those sorts of things should have occurred. And there was rubbish strewn everywhere. Thankfully, though, no permanent damage.
To hear this morning that not only had the protesters been there, but the cleaners are cleaning up urine, that I'm speechless. You know, that again, I refer to the shrine as a cathedral, as a mausoleum. Imagine holding a protest in a graveyard and urinating, and it's beyond the pale.
It was disrespectful, and it dishonoured those Australians who have made the ultimate sacrifice. And I would hope any and all who were engaged in that disgraceful behaviour would be ashamed.